What are you laughing at? The only reason that I'm fucking, the only reason I do it is Fiat 500 pass it on.
Come on, boy.
Oh yeah, mate. What colour are you calling this, Daryl?
The mint chocolate
cornetto. Yes, sir. Daryl, is this how you have to roll around in your game then? Like, just have loads of pasta pots in the boot, just in case they ever get called upon.
Told you don't go to margin and empty stuff. Bags packed.
Yeah. Yeah, I can't work out if that's your paint or you've been kicked out. In the building. So, we've got just over 3 weeks until we travel to Jamaica with Ovill Mckenzie, and we're at Commonwealth Boxing Gym this afternoon because we're gonna have a nice little mural painted on here. And we're lucky enough here in Derby that we've got Daryl Wynn, aka Soapspray. Mate, your name's talk of the town at the moment, isn't it? You're hot off the press after a couple of projects.
People have forgotten that the name's Daryl.
Like,
he's an existing character anymore.
Yeah. Just explain to us what a doodle grid is, mate, because I've seen when you did the discotheque episode.
Yeah, basically it's just a bunch of nonsense, symbols, whatever you want to, smiley faces, whatever you want to put on it, and then you overlap that doodle grid with the picture, so it's kind of like a dot to dot. So there's a grid method that you can do with squares, but like the jump's too far. This is a lot more closer to, you ain't got the jump as far, so
yeah.
And then you get some of your proportions in line, and then once your proportions there, it's just straight up your own skill then.
Yeah. For the Blue Canoe logo in Jamaica colours as a sticker being peeled off.
Yeah.
You know, at any one time, how many cans of spray paint are you having to carry around for a job?
Least about, now these days, because I use so many tones of the same colour. About 120 cans, yeah. It's like a little slightest change in the colour as it goes along makes it more 3D.
Yeah.
As when I first started, I'd only use like one or two of the same colour.
How do you keep on top of what's running out and everything else? You have to have a day where you like shake all your cans.
Sometimes you have to stamp on your can to get the last five little squirts. Like, it gets that
if it gets desperate like that, desperate, you can't get somewhere to get.
Or like, I can make my own colours because I've learned if I spray something in the can, I've got like five squirts through the nozzle, paint still in the nozzle.
Yeah.
So then I put that nozzle onto another can and it blends the colours to make my own colour, but it's a slow process.
I can imagine. Which one of your tattoos hurt the most?
The X, by far. Yeah.
Can we have a proper look at it? Come and do like a...
It needs to be a bit shaven, a bit more.
Yeah, it's a proper job, innit?
When?
Both sides.
When I've shaved my head, they look like stickers. which is what I want.
So you just basically got to emulate that look for this particular piece of artwork.
Yeah. At one point, it was like bringing that every week.
I know.
I didn't write that much.
It's just constantly in the studio, brother. I can imagine that people talk about your workload sometimes like that, though. Like, where does he get the time to be doing all these bits and bobs?
They don't know that I've got two other jobs in the week. Yeah. It's just like, I'm having to do them on the same days as working. There's no excuses. If there's something that you love doing, you will find as much time as you possibly can. You just got to love it.
True Bodge style, I've realised that I have forgotten a charger for this camera, and so I was being very particular on how much I was filming before the finished product's ready. And big up Soapspray, because he's just run out there to go and get a plug out the car. Come on! Let me show you this then. This is what is going to end up on here.
It's the first piece that you ever did properly. Have you got like a point that you'd like consider your first?
The first ever one I did was quite decent, to be fair. Because I used to look at the classed as Bibles of the graffiti world. It's Subway Art and Spray Can Art, which were books back in the 80s that everyone used to rob from W.H. Smith and draw all over the schools and stuff. And I used to just look at them all the time, and then I chose an image out of there because my first name was called Smile, believe it or not. I did one piece which was called Smile.
Yeah.
And it was like a sinister dude in an anorak with his hat on, looking like he's from New York, gangster kind of thing, with a big scary smile. And I nailed it straight away because I'd looked at that book so much. I'd never touched a can in my life, and I nailed it. And I was like, yeah, this is definitely for me.
Yeah. Why must you fight against themselves? Government leaving the youth on the shelf. Are you modelling this on anyone's hand in particular, mate?
No, it's just Google Images and... What should her name be? Cassandra?
Cassandra.
She looks like a Cassandra, like she works in an office somewhere. That was last night, so I was having it for dinner.
She's still got it in her fingernails.
Tupperware,
that's it. She's got her hands looking like Tupperware, mate, after this one. She's left-handed, though.
Oh, good night, nice one. Only left-handed brothers would know that.
That's it, mate, you know the score. This place is calling like a ghost town. No job to be found in this country. Can't go on no more. People getting hungry. Yes, I
might need a bit of something where that knuckle is.
So just talk us through this as and when, mate.
Basically, this is following the lines of an eye and having a steady hand. I've done this in the street, in the middle of town, with it blowing all down the road.
Imagine that every so often it just...
It's a bit overwhelming, you just want to scream, but yeah. You've got to stay calm.
Headbutt a lamppost. Right, we're getting down towards the business end, aren't we, Daryl?
We are indeed.
That is it, mate.
Alright, here it is.
where your tree surgery comes into it though, Darren. Having to find a makeshift.
It's like rushing off adrenaline.
I can imagine that's one of the reasons that you enjoy got into it though, is the adrenaline rush of...
To be fair, it is. A lot of it was about the adrenaline.
Yeah, we were saying that you've done a piece based out in Long Eaton for Brucey around the time that his album was launched. That was this year, wasn't it?
It was, yeah, a few months ago.
And you had a nice little visit from 5-0, didn't you?
I did.
Talk to us about it.
Yeah, I was just spraying away in a nice little jitty way and walkie-talkies come in and then bang out of nowhere, two live visitors. There was obviously dog walkers or somebody
had reported you.
They'd obviously reported me. And they were like, look, we're going to have to arrest you and take you in because this is criminal damage that you're doing on someone's property. And I said, look, it's for Brucey, it's his album launch, he's part of Long E, he's doing Carnival. Tried to get my way out, making him seem good side, it's like subjective. So I was like, look, I'm going to carry on anyway because I've invested the time this much into doing it so far. Like,
if you are going to get arrested, yeah, I might as well finish it.
So told him to go and ask the woman. The woman came out and she was like, "You leave that lad alone doing what he's doing."
Like, because it was her property, like, yeah. The other side of her wall in the jitty, kind of thing.
Yeah, and then she was like, "Leave that lad alone doing it. I really love it on the back of my ass." She was like, and then they soon changed the tone. They were like, really nice to me.
Couldn't have been nicer to you.
Yeah, that was it. Like, they started to appreciate the artwork. Yeah.
Keep on keeping on, mate. Did Brucey hear about it? Has he seen it?
Yeah, he did like a little promo video before he did the carnival with it on.
Just applying the finishing touches now.